The fundamentals of finance assume that stock prices are representative of all information available at that time, but that you cannot use that information to predict tomorrow's stock price. Over the years, however, several infringements on these rules have been documented. The infringement at the base of this research is called the idiosyncratic volatility puzzle. But what is idiosyncratic volatility? Well, it can be considered as firm-specific volatility. So the part of a firm's volatility that is different from the volatility of the market, like the S&P 500, for example. Now, firms that have higher idiosyncratic volatility in this month tend to see their stock price drop in the next month. Again, this should not be able to happen if information available now provides no information on tomorrow's stock price. Researchers have found that the idiosyncratic volatility puzzle does present itself partly due to lottery preferences of investors and market frictions. Lottery preferences can be seen as a desire to have the new Amazon or Tesla in your portfolio. And this can cause the price of those stocks to become inflated before it eventually goes back to its fundamental price for those that unfortunately do not end up being the next Tesla. Market frictions, on the other hand, are everything that prevents a trade from being executed smoothly. Examples of this are transaction costs or the bid-ask spread. Also, you have to consider that when you're playing around with millions of euros, as some people are, the prices of the stocks you are buying or selling will move accordingly. This is something called price impact. These market frictions also cause stock prices to deviate from their correct values, especially for firms with high idiosyncratic volatility. In this work, we use 8 variables that present either lottery preferences or market frictions, and we quantify just how much each variable contributes in explaining the idiosyncratic volatility puzzle. The results regarding lottery preferences are a bit mixed, but we see very clearly that the majority of the idiosyncratic volatility puzzle in European stock markets occurs due to market frictions, more specifically the bid-ask spread and price impact.